What's going on, guys? Seth Mick here. This is Native Diamond, your metal and rock podcast. All the newest in modern metal and anything related to metal.
Welcome to the Native Diamond Podcast.
Oh, shit! What you waiting for?
So, before I start today's show, I need to plug a couple of things. You can find me at Native_podcast on all social media platforms. There we can have more conversations about topics on the show. And if you're not able to watch the video, I have all audio on
all podcast platforms.
That way you can listen to the show on the go,
at work,
or whatever you're doing. Whatever it is,
I got you covered.
So without further ado, let's get into
today's review.
The review.
On today's review, I have Ozzy Osbourne's solo album, Ordinary Man.
Released February 21st.
Ozzy and Andrew Watt basically hit it off when they did Post Malone's song, Take What You Want. Then they have conversations about doing an album together. Watt calls Chad Smith. He's like,
when and where?
Then he calls Duff McKagan. Same thing. He's like,
when and where?
I want to do this album. So they all get together. Nobody's talking deals. They all just wanted to sit down and make music and just see what happened. So they were playing for 6 to 8 hours a day, and they completed the whole album in a matter of 4 days. Ozzy even goes on to say that this is the easiest album that he's ever made.
And he also did the entire album sober.
Let's kick this thing off with the guitars.
On the guitars, you have Andrew Watt, who's become a well-known studio guitarist at this point. You have Duff McKagan, who is well-known for being the bassist of Guns N' Roses.
Dope.
The guitar melodies are spot on for Ozzy. Watt does a fantastic job capturing the quintessential spirit of Ozzy. The bass has straight badass moments where it punches you in the face, or sometimes it just even
accents the song.
I really enjoyed the bass intro to Eat Me. There are so many solos in this whole album. It is so great to listen to. If you're a solo guy like myself, you're gonna have a great time listening to all these killer solos. Let's move on to the percussion. Chad Smith.
Dope.
Well known for being the drummer of Red Hot Chili Peppers.
Thrash as fuck.
It's just the little subtle things that Chad Smith does, like his intro to Holy For Tonight. Vocals and lyrics. He straight kills it. I don't know if it's because he sings with the melodies, has very simple melodies, but they
are catchy as hell.
There are times throughout this album where I feel like he's paying homage to
the Beatles,
because Ozzy is a huge Beatles fan. He mentions John Lennon so many times in any interview. The common themes throughout this whole album are themes of mortality. Ozzy is definitely coming to grips that he's not going to be alive forever. Ozzy is bringing tears to everyone's eyes with Ordinary Man. We all have a loved one, or maybe ourselves are dealing with some sort of sickness or illness that makes you just feel mortal. It's a scary thought. This whole meaning of the album, it's really a universal appeal for everybody.
Anybody could die.
It's a very relatable topic. I feel like Ozzy just crushes this whole theme throughout the album. It makes Ozzy seem very vulnerable. I think the underlying theme is also take advantage of everything that you are given and take advantage of the moment. You need to do what defines you. You want to be remembered for who you actually are.
The pros.
The song with Sir Elton John was fantastic. It is some royal shit. The guitar solos throughout the album are just so awesome to listen to. I'm such a guitar driven person.
I love listening to solos.
And there is no lack of that in this album. It's like the Beatles' White Album, but for metal. Ordinary Man is gonna be a standout album throughout time. I'm telling you, just watch. You're gonna see how well this album is reciprocated over the years. This album is a true masterpiece.
The cons.
Honestly, I don't have one. I know I'm just like an Ozzy fanboy, but I don't really have a complaint. I loved every song on this album. Yeah, it's radio. Yeah, it's commercial. But at the same time, it's Ozzy Osbourne. This is a well-constructed album, musically, lyrically, all around. Great themes. What are you complaining about?
The rating.
I'm giving this thing a solid 10. You guys are gonna be like, what the fuck? But I'm taking this thing for what it is.
It is a true masterpiece.
Thrash as fuck.
I mean, come on. You got Chad Smith. You got Duff McKagan.
Dope.
What more do you need? Andrew Watt kills it. Everything is so great in the album. I don't think it could get any better.
I'll pass this thing down to my kids. They'll pass that thing down to their kids.
Dad rock.
It's gonna be that dad rock shit that your kids complain about.
Ozzy is a true legend, and we're not gonna have another Ozzy Osbourne. This guy is epic, and he's an icon to metal, heavy metal, and classic rock. This whole album just doesn't feel dated. I love it. Go check it out today. Ozzy Osbourne's solo album, Ordinary Man, out right now on all platforms, so go and find it. Drop in a link below. Tell me at @native_podcast what you think about this album. Tell me what you think, and I'll view your response on next week's episode. So now that the review's out of the way, let's go on to the news.
The news.
For today's news, I have a lot of new releases to recommend to you guys today. First off, I have Solence, a Swedish pop metal band. It's for all you poppy metal people out there. They are really pushing boundaries with this new song called Animal in Me.
They have dropped a lyric video.
I'll drop a link below.
Also,
The Word Alive dropped their new album, Monomania,
through Fearless Records
on February 21st. This is definitely a highly recommend from me.
The Word Alive,
a post-hardcore band coming from Sacramento, California.
Craig Mabbitt's old band.
No, I'm just kidding.
Tyler Smith has fortified his spot with The Word Alive. His clean vocals are phenomenal. Monomania means an obsession with one particular thing.
For me, I guess it's metal and metal reviews.
This is a great rock album that you need to check out if you're into cleans, a little bit of screaming, incorporating a lot of pop elements. Go check out The Word Alive with their new album today. Speaking of rock bands that introduce a lot of pop, I have Dance Gavin Dance's new song,
Prisoner.
Tillian Pearson's vocals shine in this song. They have interesting guitar and melodies. I love the ambience and the echo effect throughout the song. Go check out Dance Gavin Dance. Also, I have two releases for you from Stay Sick Records. Dealer with their new EP Saint. They are called one of the hottest upcoming bands. They are super heavy, and off the EP, I enjoyed Violent Stimuli. So go ahead and check them out. Also, Dropout Kings released their new track Glitch Gang. So if you're into like new metal, rap metal, trap metal, whatever, here's a good song for you. It's not corny, super catchy. I don't know what you want to call it. It's rap, it's metal, it's dope.
Dope.
I'm dropping all these links below for all the songs that I mentioned.
Tell me what you think at @native_podcast.
And Ghostmane. Ghostmane put out a creepy ass video. He dropped this video on February 18th on YouTube, showing the upcoming release of his new album. Super fucking creepy. Gives off this like Marilyn Manson vibe. This whole topic inspires my next segment, The Rant.
The Rant!
So on today's rant, I want to push the boundaries. Are we accepting rap and metal at this point? Are we going to put that into our metal genre? Are we just going to push it away and say that's not us? No matter what you say, there's no denying that rap and metal are always going to be in some kind of cohesion. Look at
Limp Bizkit.
And now there's nu metal purist and elitist, which is hilarious because nu metal was not a popular thing when it was around.
A lot of people kind of shit on it.
What spawns this whole topic of
a nu metal resurgence?
Well, we have artists like Poppy, who's touring with Deftones and Gojira. You have Scarlord going on tour with Bring Me the Horizon. And you have Ghostmane, who's just like popping up at random festivals. I know he's gonna be at Epicenter. Metal just isn't in the spotlight anymore. Whose fault is that? Well, it's no one's fault really per se, because no one has really stepped up and tried to be that whole Fred Durst
mainstream metal.
Either you love or you hate that type of metal. And you're gonna love or hate this type of nu metal. So should we accept them? Should we not? I think you should. I think we should all be accepting of all new things coming into our genre. This is 2020, so obviously things are growing and things have expanded into different possibilities. Ghostmane reminds me of Marilyn Manson, but a rap 3-6 Mafia version. And Poppy is fucking Poppy.
I'm Poppy. I'm Poppy. I'm Poppy. I'm Poppy. I'm Poppy.
weird, meaningless, whatever.
It seems like she kind of switched up her genre, but it works for her. She's like this weird, creepy little girl with a metal band behind her who is actually pretty decent. So we're probably gonna see a lot more of Poppy as her numbers seem to just keep going up. And Ghostmane. Scarlord, Ghostmane, and Poppy have over 1 million listeners on Spotify. Unfortunately, if you look at other metal bands like Napalm Death, Converge, aren't even in the million range.
A lot of them are in that 200k range.
So obviously, Ghostmane, Poppy, Scarlord, they're bringing a lot of attention to the metal scene because
their relevance is making other bands relevant again.
Poppy just got signed to Sumerian Records. Artists like Little Lotus just got signed to Epitaph. Scarlord right now is with Island Records, but Poppy was with Island Records.
You don't know what Scarlord's next step could be.
Isn't Limp Bizkit essentially just Fred Durst with a band behind him?
It's the same thing.
Whether or not you agree with this or not, I feel like you're gonna see more solo artists
under the metal category
because that's just the direction that we're going with music.
Marilyn Manson is a solo act.
And nowadays, we're just gonna capitalize on a specific artist with an image or a look. That's the future. Unfortunately,
we live in a capitalist society, so what can you do?
That pretty much does it for the rants.
Please be accepting of new artists coming up.
And give it a chance. That will always be the spiel of the show. Moving on from today's rant, let's get into the list.
The list.
So, if you're unfamiliar with the list, I have a Spotify playlist called Diamonds in the Rough. I put on all the newest metal songs that I can find, so go check out Diamonds in the Rough on Spotify. My top five of the list is always on that playlist. So, without further ado, let's get into my countdown called The List. The list.
Coming in at number five.
I have Slaves with their single, Bury a Lie.
I have been enjoying it a lot.
It's a hard rock song. Go check out Slaves, Bury a Lie, coming in at number five.
Number four.
Coming in at number four, I have Bury Tomorrow, an English metalcore band coming out with their new single, Choke.
In lieu of today's review.
Coming in at number three.
Ozzy Osbourne, Under the Graveyard, the Prince of Darkness.
Coming in at number two.
I have Polaris with Vagabond. Polaris just dropped their new album last Friday on the 21st. What a time to be alive.
So, last but not least,
I am left with
Song of the Week. On today's Song of the Week, I have The Amity Affliction, which is why I'm wearing my fucking
flat bill hat.
If you couldn't guess it, it was right there the whole time. You were just staring at it and you had no idea. The Amity Affliction with their new single, Forever. This is coming off their new album, Everyone Loves You Once You Leave Them, which was released through
Pure Noise Records on February 21st.
Joel Birch, the lead vocalist, goes on to say, this album is about the dichotomy of thought during a depressive episode.
Like bipolar thinking.
This constant want to end your life, but at the same time you know that you're just gonna leave everyone else behind in the darkness.
Yeah, it's kind of a sad topic.
Probably not the most popular topic, but Amity Affliction always kind of talks about this type of thing. This whole like mental illness, mental awareness thing. And I enjoy it because they shine a light on mental illness, lets you know that it does feel vulnerable and it happens to a lot more people than you think. Amity also goes on to say they have refound their love for heavy music. They go on to say they were experimenting a lot, but they basically found the perfect combination of new and old Amity, so that way it's the perfect blend for all fans of Amity Affliction. They're just trying to give the fans what they want, and it proves to be successful. I enjoyed Coffin, their opener. Overall, I enjoyed this album as a whole. It does feel like Amity is back on with their fans. They're just trying to make
everyone happy
and themselves as well. I loved it. I had a lot of fun listening to it. So if you're going through something, this might be the album for you. Joel Birch is a dope vocalist.
Dope.
And you got Aaron with the supporting vocals on the bass. The heaviness is back. Amity Affliction is back. Songs I enjoyed off their album were
Soak Me in Bleach,
Baltimore Rain,
Forever,
and Catatonia. Go check them out today with their new album. Drop it a link below at @native_podcast. Tell me what you think about this new album or today's song of the week. Moving on from the list, today's
Hidden Gem.
Hidden Gems.
Until the World Goes Cold by Trivium. They released this single on August 26, 2015 through Roadrunner Records. And all the members were involved in the songwriting throughout this album. They have always written their own lyrics and music. Matt Hafey, he is an elite metal guitarist and singer. When this song was released, it peaked at number 10 on Billboard's mainstream rock chart. This is essential metal.
For all you metalheads,
you need to add this to your repertoire. Until the world goes cold. I know you've probably all heard of it, but if you haven't, I need to tell you about Trivium, because
Trivium is an awesome band.
You're gonna have dope guitar throughout this whole thing.
Dope.
They have a nice chug to them. Their solos are always fucking fierce. I love the thought process that goes into their art. Matt Hafey is half Japanese, half American, if you didn't know. He incorporates a lot of Japanese themes into his albums, as shown their album art. You can go to trivium.org and find out some background information about the art and the thought process behind the album. So there it is, today's hidden gem, Until the World Goes Cold. Get at me at native_podcast. Let me know what you thought about today's hidden gem. And you can also recommend a hidden gem that can be featured on next week's episode, so get on that. That pretty much does it for today's show. Short, sweet, to the point this week. I'm actually not feeling the fucking best, so I'm gonna get out of here.
I'm gonna drink some DayQuil.
And I'll get back to work and stop crying like a little bitch. All I need you to do is hit subscribe, ring the bell, that way you are notified every Friday I drop a new episode of Native Diamond Podcast. I hope you enjoyed today's show, and as always, shine on.
It's gonna be that dad rock shit that your kids complain about.